her fifth Tour Championship title, and what a year it's been for Graf. Her opponent, Martina Hingis, at 16 years of age, could be the game's next great player. Steffi Graf and Martina Hingis, perhaps the greatest player against a future number one player of the world, Martina Hingis. ABC Sports presents the Chase Championships of the Corral WTA Tour. The only best of five sets final in the women's game, featuring four-time defending champion Steffi Graf and the up-and-coming 16-year-old Martina Hingis. Hello again, everyone. I'm Robin Roberts. Throughout the year, players play in tournaments to accumulate points to earn the right to come here to New York City for the Chase Championships. Only 16 players, the top 16, are invited to come. Steffi Graf and Martina Hingis are in the final. Perhaps it could be an indication of what we saw earlier in the week. On Monday, we bid farewell to the popular Gabriella Sabatini. On Tuesday, Monica Seles retired with a bad shoulder. And we said so long to Kamiko Date with a ceremony. On Wednesday, emotions ran high, and the game of Arantxa Sanchez Vicario soared. Day four turned into frustration for Lindsay Davenport. That same night, Eva Maioli turned pain in the game, upsetting Conchita Martinez. Friday was a sad night as Kamiko Date played for the final time and Gigi Fernandez and Natasha Zvereva played their last match together. And yesterday, Yana Novotna gave it her all but lost to Graf. And Eva Maioli just didn't have enough to beat the new Martina. And it has already been a memorable week. Taking a look at the draw from the quarters on, Steffi Graf had no problem advancing to the semifinals. There she was taken to three sets by Yana Novotna before winning. Same goes for Martina Hingis, moving on to the semis easily before taken to three sets by Eva Maioli. And I'm joined for this match by Betsy Nagelson and Pam Shriver. It is an intriguing matchup, Pam. We have the rookie Martina Hingis going up against Steffi Graf, who's anything but.
Well, Steffi Graf, another spectacular year at the Grand Slams, winning all three that she entered. However, since the U.S. Open, she entered two tournaments and was unable to complete either one. Last week in Philadelphia, had to default after losing the first set to Yana Novotna because of her bad back, which has become chronic. Here you can see she's shaking her head, ready to retire in the match. This week, though, due to a good schedule, couple days of rest, and no back-to-back matches until today, the back's feeling pretty good, but she has to play three out of five sets. She is familiar with the injury issue.
Seeing the physical problems that I've had the past two or three years and to still be winning all these major tournaments seems a little odd to me, even though I always play well when it comes down on the big points or the big matches. But still, with the little training that I have, to still have that success, is, I don't know what to say. Maybe it doesn't really speak all the way for the women's tennis in the moment.
Well, Steffi doesn't give herself enough credit. She is compiling the greatest record in the history of women's singles. She's kind of like women's tennis version of Michael Jordan. They don't come along very often.
Well, that's pretty good company. She alluded to the lack of depth in the women's game, but Betsy, come on, she's playing a 16-year-old. The future does look bright.
For Martina Hingis, it certainly does. I mean, I think most people in tennis, when they saw Hingis come along, knew they were looking at a future number one, and it just may happen sooner than a lot of people expected. She has been playing some of the best tennis of anyone in the last couple of months. She reached the semifinals of the U.S. Open, her first ever Grand Slam semi, and since then she has played unbelievable tennis. She's won 20 of the last 22 matches she's played, two titles, and just a couple of weeks ago on a surface similar to this, annihilated Monica Seles 6-2, 6-love. She's up against Graf, a player she's beaten before, and happy to be here.
Yeah, it was like my little dream to qualify to this tournament, and last year I only could watch on TV and or some of the first matches, only could pick up my newcomer award, and now I'm here and standing in the final, so it's a great feeling.
So the stage is set. Steffi versus Martina. Haven't seen that in the garden since 1989. Okay, that was Martina Navratilova, the first of many references, I'm sure. Come on back. Plenty of tennis ahead, everyone.
I'm Walter Shipley, chairman of the Chase Manhattan Bank. Let me say how very pleased we are to be sponsoring these exciting championship matches. It's a natural fit for us. The qualities these great athletes possess are values we at Chase try to live by, both in serving our customers and relating to each other as colleagues. Respect for the individual, teamwork, a striving for excellence, and the recognition that we have to earn our reputation every day. Thanks for looking in, and our very best wishes for a happy Thanksgiving.
Back here live. Madison Square Garden. Remember, this is the only best of five final in the women's game. Steffi Graf and the 16-year-old Martina Hingis, the hottest player of the fall.
And Steffi Graf, of course, very familiar face. Number one in the world. Seated number one here.
And Steffi will serve first against Martina Hingis. An appreciative crowd is always on hand in the garden. Remember, it's a best of five.
She plays with no fear. I mean, a 16-year-old, she can afford that.
And Graf falls down, falls left 30 on her serve.
Well, she's 27 years old. She has residences actually all over the world, including New York City, one in South Florida. Of course, she's a German native.
Martina Hingis, just her first appearance in the season-ending championships.
And just 16 years old, two months ago. And she was born in Slovakia, and at 7 years old, moved to a small town in Switzerland.
Wants to go up and take a look at it, just to make sure. Calling the action from the chair is Jane Harvey, always in command of the match.
One of the most experienced umpires on the Corral Tour, and that's something players love to see, a familiar face up top there.
Everyone. How many winners was that for Hingis? One winner.
Okay, thank you. Martina Hingis, her first service game. She's up one love.
Thing in this match, if Graf can produce enough winners, because Hingis is going to get a lot of balls back. She's going to try to draw errors from Graf. Graf made a couple of errors in the first game. That's the thing right there that Hingis does so well. I mean, from nowhere, she can just boom, win her down the line.
It's a smart play to hit the second serve wide to the forehand, because then it opens up the backhand side of the court. She's having to hit a lot of second serves. She only served 53% coming into this match, and Graf can really punish some of these second serves.
And again, the touch to Graf. Two break points for Graf.
Well, this time you see some of the touch from Steffi Graf, the finesse backhand. We're used to seeing her hit the slice. It's perfect. It looks just like her drive, except she cups it, takes some of the pace off. And the first really brilliant point of the match. I always feel at the start of a big match, you don't feel great until you've had one of those rallies where you've run all over the court and you get that heart rate up. And I expect now in the third game for the players start to settle down and start to play some really good tennis.
Into the net. Hingis is a player who likes to be at the net. She'll take advantage of anything short. She'll move in. She's got tremendous strategy and court sense, Martina Hingis.
And an ace there by Steffi Graf.
Number one for Graf.
And this weekend, every time there's an ace, $250 will be donated to Hall of Famer Althea Gibson, who is ill.
Well, it's great for Althea that Steffi Graf is in the tournament, because that was her 19th ace for the tournament.
Only counts for the weekend, though. So once again, both players struggling with their serve.
That's the first time Graf has missed her first serve.
Well, that tells you something interesting about Martina Hingis, because she broke Steffi Graf in the first game and was leading 15-30 when Graf did miss her first serve. So that means that Hingis is not intimidated by the power of Graf's first serve. Look at her standing right along the baseline. Perfect timing there. Can't help some of those. I mean, Graf hits the extremes very well on the serve on both sides. She also loves on this ad side hitting the big one out wide.
Thank you.
Our first deuce game.
Just wide.
But it's something that Martina Hingis does well. She missed that one just by a couple inches wide, but she changes direction of the flight of the ball as well as anyone on the tour right now. She went cross court with the return, and then she tried for the almost the winner up the line.
Her third ace. Steffi is the first to hold serve, and she leads 2-1 in the first set. Live. Hingis leading 40 love. She's down 1-2 in the first set.
She's actually picked up the pace of her first serve. Hit a couple of serves that Groff didn't hit back. Matter of fact, that's the third one of the game. So it's a great confidence builder for the 16-year-old, having dropped her opening service game to come back and hold to love.
What was that, 30 seconds perhaps? Goodness. It's best of five, Martina, best of five.
A million times from Steffi Graf, a forehand winner. Here you see number one, and look at that career earnings heading towards over 20 million. There's only one other woman player that's crossed 20 million.
Oh, I know.
Okay, Robin, go ahead.
The other Martina.
Of prize money and millions, last week and 2 weeks ago, Martina Hingis became the youngest ever to go over the $1 million mark.
Still a long way to 20, though.
Give her time.
Take the overhead and go behind her here. Hingis on the stretch just holds her ground, and that compact, deadly backhand down the line. She reads the ball so very well. People talk about how well Hingis moves, how much he has improved her movement, but she does anticipate so well.
Has two more break points.
The other thing about Hingis is her movements oftentimes seem effortless. She has great balance, and when she takes her racket back, it's such a natural thing. She hits on the run very well, and that forehand volley just wide from Graf.
Well played from Graf. Opened up this match with a couple of breaks. Still a break point here for Hingis.
And Graf loves to go cross court with that slice backhand. Everybody knows it. So when she goes up the line, a lot of times you are leaning left.
Well, anything in the middle of the court, you can say goodbye to. Best feet in the game. They never stop. And a little look of frustration. I'm not happy about the forehand.
She's such a perfectionist.
God, when I fight off a break point, I'm kind of happy about it.
My Steffi's in two she fought off.
Takes it a lot to make Steffi happy.
Talking to herself a little bit. Advantage Graf. After being down 15-40.
Service game in a row that Graf has had to go into deuce game. Server's having a tough time early.
Set that up with a big serve. Took Hingis out of court. The 11th winner from Graf. Just see how stretched out Hingis is trying to play the return. Graf is able to step in and wrong foot Hingis again. She sure didn't look happy again after that forehand winner, though.
Oh, it's called out, so Steffi is able to hold to go up 3-2. Chase Championships of the Corral WTA Tour will continue after this from our ABC stations.
Yeah.
Thank you. Sure.
30 out.
Well, Martina at least waited a while. Good.
Back live here, Madison Square Garden. Hingis falling, love 15.
It's an example of the second serve from Hingis that was not good enough, and Graf was all over it. And Hingis is going to have to be very careful with her second serves throughout this match.
Yet another second serve, Steffi will get.
Ooh, there's the bouncing of the racket that we've become accustomed to seeing somewhat with Hingis as we look at their head-to-head. 4-1 for Graf. Their last meeting was, of course, the semifinals of the U.S. Open. And Martina Hingis had 5 set points in that first set. Could not capitalize on any of them.
And her one win came at the Italian Open in the against Steffi Graf. It's always a good chance that you can wrong foot an opponent when you bring them to an extreme side. There, Graf thinks Hingis is going to go back cross court.
Hingis has such a complete game.
She really does. She can do everything. She can mix up the spin, the speed of the ball. She can create great angles. I mean, tactically speaking, she's one of the smartest players out there today.
You know, it sort of sounds silly, but this is the beginning of her third year on the tour. I mean, she is becoming a young veteran, mm-hmm. even though she's 16 and she's still setting age records.
She vaulted in the top 15 only 8 months after she joined the tour. Then she hovered around 18 to 20 for about a year. It's a break point here.
Ooh, and that's a forehand return that Graf would like to have back. It was sitting there for her to hit. She did hit it, but she just didn't close her racket face enough, hit it long. An opportunity lost.
And Hingis battles back. Advantage Hingis.
You just love it when you play Graf, when she gives you two free points like that. When you're serving, she didn't hit good serves there, but Graf made it easy.
Doesn't happen often.
Nope.
Off this short ball, but Graf was just too good here. She had an open court. Hingis knows how to volley. I mean, she won the doubles this year at Wimbledon with Helena Suková.
Hand side there, and then look how she changes direction down the line. So few people can do it that accurately.
She makes it look so easily. It's the most difficult shot in tennis to change the direction of the ball like that. A couple of drop shots that Graf has played, that one paid off for. Hingis in that doubles win this year with Helena Suková became the youngest ever Wimbledon champion. Got a lot of confidence from that win.
Back to deuce. And just long.
Some brilliant shot making and improvising from Martina Hingis. The backhand slice up the line from Graf was right on the sideline. Hingis did a terrific job just to get to it and flicked her wrist.
And Hingis holds. It's now 3-all in the first set. We've got the top money winners in tennis here. Coming up next, the LPGA Tour's top money winners battle in the Vegas desert. It's the ITT LPGA Tour Championship. Laura Davies and Kari Webb are battling for the money title. Kari Webb, one of the co-leaders, and Laura Davies just three shots back.
Yesterday, right off the bat, she started to attack because she knew if she didn't, that Novotna would. She's a little bit more reluctant to come to the net against Hingis. Hingis is pinning her to the baseline. But it sure worked well for her yesterday.
Power of Hingis, 15-all.
I think Steffi Graf could do well in this match by staying a little more away from that two-handed side of Hingis. Play the forehand more. It's also a better chance. Hingis hits a forehand. She's going to go back cross-court to Graf's forehand, which is the side that she wants to punish Hingis with. You see Graf ahead on the winners, but not by much. 30. It's been a very clean match so far. A lot of winners, not too many unforced errors. That last one from Hingis was more of a forced error. You could see the power from Steffi put Hingis in a tough position.
Oh! 40-15, Graf.
And the drop shot for Graf to go up 4-3 in the first of this best of five final.
These have been emotional times for the Graf family. We asked Steffi Graf what it's been like since her father was released from prison on bail 10 days ago.
No question about it. We've been waiting for that moment for 1.5 years, and it's been pretty difficult, especially not being home in the moment. But during the period since the U.S. Open, I've been every week to see him in the jail. So, I mean, it's not like I haven't seen him for a long time, but I always say I'm going to look forward to seeing him soon.
It has been a long ordeal for Steffi Graf, her father facing tax evasion charges. And she wins the first point for the eighth game.
And she's here this week with her mother, Heidi, who, of course, has been through an equally tough ordeal, although she doesn't have to face the questions as much as her daughter.
Just along, it's amazing how Steffi is able to concentrate and play tennis with all that's going on in her life.
It's her sanctuary.
What all she accomplished last year during it all, three of the four Grand Slams that she played. Only lost two matches, won 9 of the 11 tournaments in.
For Steffi Graf, her mother Heidi, who is here with her. A lot of support she gives her daughter.
Steffi Graf's longtime coach, Heinz Gunhardt, also here with her as her boyfriend. Michael has been here as well. So her support system, minus one, has been intact this week.
It's Graf with the break.
There's Heinz Gunhardt, who's been with Steffi for about 6 years now. Seen her through 9 Grand Slam wins.
Ironically, from the country of Switzerland, where Hingis is from, former number one player. Of course, he would have heard about Martina Hingis probably when she was about 7 or 8 years old.
Hingis, so cool. And her mother, her coach, who named her daughter after Martina Navratilova.
And has she been able to balance a very difficult and delicate job to balance the life of a young tennis professional?
A prodigy, really.
Of course, the reason why her mother named her after Martina is Melanie is from the Czech Republic and is pretty close to Martina's age. Graf in serving for this first set, now up 30-15 in a 3-out-of-5 set match. Of course, it takes on a little different storyline, but getting out to that one set lead is huge, because then the other person has to win three of the next four to get out of the match the victor.
Graf getting off to a much better start here than they did the last time we met at the U.S. Open, when it was Hingis who got off to a 5-3 lead in that first set. She certainly knows what it's like to play the top players. She's beaten 9 of the top 10 this year, and she's beaten 3 of them twice.
When Steffi Graf stretches you out so far to your backhand side to be able to get it to the Graf backhand, the forehand is always waiting. That's the shot Steffi Graf wants.
Left to be played here at the Chase Championships at the Correll WTA Tour. So come on back. A look back to 1996 first Grand Slam of the year, the Australian Open. And what a way to start the year for Monica Seles. Against Anke Huber in the final, Seles played consistently enough to capture her first Grand Slam win since her return to tennis. Australian, the only Grand Slam tournament that Steffi Graf did not play in. Back live here at Madison Square Garden, Steffi Graf taking the first set 6-3. First game of the second set.
Matter of fact, Graf did not play in a tournament until the Indian Wells tournament, and that's in March. So we're used to her having a lot of injuries.
Of course, Monica Seles was here, went out in the first round, and really struggling with that shoulder and had to retire at 5-4 down in the first set to Kamiko Date. A real disappointment for Monica.
Well, Hing is trying a little different tactic there. She was serving and volleying, but it was almost like a delay serve volley. I don't know whether she was confused as to what she wanted, but now 3 break points.
Right, she was there for that backhand volley.
Hingis did a great job to survive that point. She was in deep trouble from the moment Graf pounds this shot. A half volley backhand flick up the line. Graf really has this backhand volley. She missed a lot of backhand volleys yesterday in the net when she was playing Novotna.
Still 2 break points.
Well played from Hingis there. Graf has just pinned Hingis to the baseline. I mean, Graf has struck far more winners than errors.
But Graf comes through with the early break in this best of 5 Chase Championships final.
Serena Hingis, and you're back with the Chase Championships.
The youth of Martina Hingis is 16 years old. She's been really refreshing.
Yeah, and she speaks English very well. Matter of fact, she kind of serves as her translator from her mother, who struggles a bit with the language.
What's it going to take for her to... It's still a lot of tennis to be played, but down a break already.
Well, Steffi Graf's playing a very clean match. She has very few unforced errors, and she's going to need to give Martina Hingis some help by missing a few shots.
Just a bit long, 15 all.
Just an inch or two, and that's the kind of point she needs. She was up love 15, trying to get up love 30 on the Graf serve to break back.
Oh.
Ooh. Serve 91 miles an hour.
Thought she had her fourth ace there.
This gives you an idea of what happened in the first set.
Look at the unforced errors, only 7 for Graf. And remember, she has the high-risk game. She's going for it. She has 16 winners. Break chances, 2 of 3, only 1 for 3 for Hingis.
Good serving numbers, too, from Graf at 74 miles per hour, because she goes for her serve.
Yeah, at 74%, that's very good throughout this championship. Graf has been serving at about the mid-60s, and that's a very good performance to raise that up to the mid-70s.
Now she faces 2 break points.
The crowd here at Madison Square Garden is able to break back quickly. Back on serve at 1-1 in the second set. Tomorrow night, after breaking a share of NFL records, Dan Marino looks for a win at home. The Dolphins have their hands full against the Pittsburgh Steelers. ABC NFL Monday Night Football right here on ABC Sports, 9 Eastern. For it, that's for sure.
Hingis's serving percentages have gone up a little bit in this first set compared to her average for the week. She's been just above the 50% mark.
Shy away from the net. It is terrific to see how brave she is. A great half volley pickup. This is where doubles maybe helps her out. Terrific stretch. She leans forward towards the net, which helps cut off that angle.
She was doing that even in the juniors, Pam, wasn't she? Remember when she was the youngest ever to win the French junior title in 93 and followed up with another win in 94. And she used drop shots, came to the net on the slow red clay a lot.
Gets it back to 30 all.
And that was one of her best serves of the match at 88 miles an hour, and it came at a good time, down 15-30. She has not held serve since the 6th game of the first set, dropping her last couple.
And it's Graf with yet another break point.
Yes.
boys.
You can just see she really wants that two-handed backhand. The way Graf maybe wants a forehand, she stepped around that and just clobbered the two-hander.
Like it was about to come over. Stayed on Hingis' side of the net. Advantage Graf.
Second break point. And five breaks already.
Of the Correll WTA Tour will continue after this from our ABC stations.
Okay, thanks. Well, we've got an hour of doubles.
Yeah, that's true. It's a lot of doubles.
We'll be doing it.
And enjoying it nonetheless. Live here at Madison Square Garden. Steffi Graf up a break, leading 2-1 in the second set. A rare unforced error by Graf.
Actually, it was actually a very good forehand return from Hingis right in the corner.
She comes back with a 93-mile-an-hour serve.
Number four.
That's $1,000 for Althea Gibson. Again, every ace worth $250 goes to Althea Gibson, who's not doing well these days. First African-American woman to win the championships, Wimbledon and the U.S. Open. Former number one player here in this country and the world for that matter. That's a rare gift.
Second error in this game.
Well, that's what Hingis needs from Graf right now is she needs some errors, and it's the forehand side that can break down as a match goes along. For a 3-1 lead, and the lob that Hingis placed up, we're right about on level with a big scoreboard that drops down in the garden. I don't know how much that missed the scoreboard by, but it must have just been by an inch or two.
Not much.
Selection, but there was a time where she made the wrong choice especially coming after Groff had missed a couple of forehands in a row. Groff didn't have to hit one forehand there. I would have given Groff a little bit of a test on the deuce point. Made her hit a few forehands.
And it's Groff. And Steffi Graf holds to take a 3-1 lead in the second set. And it's been another remarkable year for Steffi Graf. She still has the same problems, but the results are still the same. 6 titles in 96.
Of course, she's at 21 Grand Slam singles titles, moved ahead of Martina and Chris. Only Margaret Court at 24 has more than Steffi Graf. And she's still only 27 years old.
She's trying to get to victory number 7. The last 10, 11 years, she's won at least 7 tournaments a year. Incredible.
Every year since she won her first title in 1986, she won 8 that year. Ace number 1 from Hingis.
Adding to the Althea Gibson Fund, who is having some health problems, in need of some help.
Well, Hingis would be happy to hold on to her serve here. She has been busted the last 3 times she served.
From the forehand.
Well, and she looked like having a good, comfortable service game, up 40 love, but the last 2 points, including this blast of a forehand return for a clean winner, brings it back to 40-30.
Kept going back to that spot, and Hingis is able to hold. But Groff is still up 3-2 here at the Chase Championships of the Corral WTA Tour. A look back to a classic French Open final between Steffi Graf and Arantxa Sanchez Vicario. In a seesaw match, the players battled through an 18-game third set. Graf's 5th title came only after winning 10-8 in the final set. And back live here in New York City.
Boy, Sanchez Vicario and Graf have played some memorable finals in Grand Slams the last couple years. Wimbledon final year and a half ago was outstanding. Graf won that one 7-5 in the third. Played a 30-point 11th game.
That was incredible.
It was. Well, again, I just see some shaky signs on this forehand, and of course it's a tough decision to go to the forehand side, but you have to be aware in a match when a side maybe is starting to break down a little bit and go to it a little more.
That's what Hingis just can't afford, even though that was a good serve and had some stick on it, 90 miles per hour, but Hingis has got to make Graf play, because Graf can maybe make some errors, which he has done here in the second set a little bit. Got 5 unforced errors in this second set.
Wow, and that first serve missed by the whole width of the doubles alley.
That's not easy to do. Using the court is Hingis. Wow.
She can draw those angles so well, Hingis, because she's not afraid to move in and take the ball very early. And the closer you are to the net, the easier the angles are to play. How far out of court Steffi is makes this forehand winner easier.
Well, that's a tough one for Hingis, because so many times Graf on big points on the ad side likes to go out wide. That one she nailed perfectly down the center. Some terrific serving on big points. It's pretty even there.
And a break point for Hingis.
And it's three times in a row that she's been able to win the points on the deuce side, and she's trying to look for her first one on this ad side. But Graf needs to help her out by not hitting one of those huge first serves.
Fifth break opportunity here for Hingis. She's got herself two breaks. She's been able to break Graf twice.
As we see Melanie, Hingis's mom, gives Hingis more trouble than the forehand sometimes because it stays so low. It's tough for Hingis to dig it out.
Graf has one of the best slices in the game. And she not only keeps the ball very, very low with the slice, but she can really knife it. It's got a lot of speed on it. Long point. Hingis is a little bit winded. She desperately needs this one here.
I love to see parents on this tour, you know. They're always so relaxed.
A parent and a coach in that instance.
To come through with the break, evening at 3-all here in the second set. Saturday night, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC Sports. Our primetime matchup, college football, Lou Holtz's final regular season game as Notre Dame's head football coach, the Fighting Irish, and USC. That's a classic. That's Saturday night right here on ABC Sports. Bob Davey officially named Holtz's replacement at Notre Dame. Again, going for it early in the game.
Well, Hingis would love to try and take a lead in this second set, trying to serve for 4-3. And again, it's a forehand that misses from Graf. The last few games, we've seen a lot of those errors from the forehand side. Put a little pressure on Graf having to serve at 3-4.
Has such a wide variety to choose from. That one, she tried to take the angle cross court. But against Mioli yesterday, we were watching that match, and a couple times she was on the run like that. And on the two-hander, she'd throw up the topspin lob for a winner.
We have seen that play often from Steffi Graf today, the drop shot, the finesse slice backhand. Graf right now is showing more variety off the backhand side than the forehand.
Graf 2 points away, a point away in 4-3 lead. And the double fault, and the frustrated Martina Hingis, as she is broken yet again, and is down 3-4. Steffi Graf serving to go up 5-3. It's the Chase Championships. Another excellent crowd on hand here at Madison Square Garden for the only best of five final in women's tennis. Steffi Graf and Martina Hingis, just 16 years old. She trails 6-3, 3-4 in the second. Yes.
Hingis at love 30 is 2 points away from making it 3 breaks in a row and 6 total for this second set.
Miles an hour, that serve.
From Graf, set up by the big, deep forehand. Allows her to put the volley away with comfort. She loves to move to her left so she can play that inside-out forehand. That's her favorite shot. Good volleying technique. Her numbers have changed, though, in the second set. She's got 10 unforced errors to only 4 winners.
Chance. Well, it's the old swinging volley that we see a lot of times now. You saw Graf 2 points ago hit the more traditional forehand volley, but the topspin volley from Hingis forces the issue, gives her 2 break points. They're still just playing 1 point at a time, but I do think Graf is giving Hingis a window. She's made a lot of unforced errors, and Hingis needs to take advantage of that right here at 4-all, down a set. She needs to hold serve.
As Martina Navratilova used to say, stay in the now.
That's right. I mean,
just 1 point.
For Hingis, obviously, this is uncharted territory. She's never played a 3 out of 5. Graf's done it many times.
Graf's won this 4 times, this event. And of course, it's Hingis' first ever trip to the championships.
Deep by Graf. 15-all.
Good aggressive play. Steffi Graf only made 7 unforced errors in the first set. She's got 12 already in the second set.
Right on the line, even though Graf had enough time to hit a forehand, it was aggressive enough. She couldn't take charge. And on that first serve, she took a lot of pace off. She only hit it 72 miles an hour, and that's another good tactic against Graf. Don't always go for your first serve on big points. Get it in.
Hinga's a point away from taking the lead in the second set.
And she does. She takes a 5-4 lead. When we come back, Steffi Graf will serve to stay in this second set. More of the Correll WTA Tour Championships in a moment.
Back here, and it's Martina Hingis with a 5-4 lead in the second set. She has been playing extremely well this fall, and we asked her about her growing confidence.
I got much more confident, especially in my game, and since Wimbledon, when I won my doubles title, I know I can win the whole tournament, and I took it over to the singles, and then I just practiced a lot before the US Open, and it happened there that I won round after round. I beat great players there, and I went to the semis, and it was a very good feeling to be there, and after that I won my first tournament, so I just got much more confidence, and mentally especially.
Now I heard what inspired her to win that first tournament in Filderstadt, the Porsche. No 16-year-old wants that Porsche.
Well, that great depth gives Hingis now just 2 points from this second set, but I also love the fact that she refers to winning that Wimbledon doubles title and the confidence that she gained from winning the title with Helena Suková. Incidentally, they are splitting up.
Just misses that. A lot of doubles teams are splitting up this year.
It's typical of the end of the year, but this year probably more so than other years. Hingis is going to concentrate a little bit more on her singles next year, and it's going in right now without a regular partner.
I think the doubles was very, very good for her, though, in many instances. I think it added a whole social element to it. She became very good friends with her partner last year, Eva Mioli. It's also improved her game. I mean, she's really learned and been able to practice serving and volleying. She and Suková have got a couple of doubles titles.
Little inexperienced the last 2 points coming from Hingis. She was love 30 on the Graf serve. Needed to put pressure on Graf by getting a lot of balls back, but didn't. She was going for the offensive winner, Hingis was, and Graf didn't have enough time to time it.
Martina's mom, very pensive at this moment.
She's seen a few tight points, and she'll see a lot more. Again, the face of Martina Hingis. Not yet one on her mom's face. This was just an incredible get number one, and then to defend right here.
We were speaking about the doubles just a couple of seconds ago, and this is an example of how the doubles can help you. Reflex volleys.
She is not intimidated at the net at all. She opens up the third set.
One set all. Just misses. One set all. Remember, this is a best of five.
Of hers, that two-hander down the line where she changes direction of the ball. She started in this match, early in this match, doing it, hitting winners off of it. It's incredible how well she hits that ball. It's a very high-risk shot.
High risk because it's over the high part of the net.
Great placement by Graf.
Net cord helped Steffi Graf there, gave her plenty of time to set up and hit topspin backhand pass. Surprise, surprise, server in a little bit of trouble.
No. In this match?
How many breaks have there been?
10.
Y'all set each other up very well.
To me, it's not that surprising there are that many breaks. Hingis is one of the best returners in the game. She is facing Graf, one of the better servers, but that kind of negates it. And Hingis does not have a big serve for a weapon, although that was a pretty good one.
And she saves one break point.
Her serve actually has improved a lot. She's never worked on her serve because she was still in the developmental stages and just didn't want to overwork anything, didn't want to give herself any injuries. But as she's gotten stronger, her serve has improved.
2 weeks ago when she beat Sella 6-2, 6-love, her serve was quite a factor in that match. She had a lot of service winners.
Gutsy play.
When you fight off a break point with a slice backhand drop shot that's perfectly disguised, you could see her take back was the same as her two-handed shot. At this last minute, she released her left hand. It's perfect. We've seen some good drop shots from Graf, but that one was the best one yet.
Balker left something on the
Whoa! How to be embarrassed at Madison Square Garden as a ball girl.
Point for Graf.
That slice that Graf hits, that inside-out slice, because the ball hits and moves away, and not only stays very low, but after it bounces, it goes off another few inches. It makes you have to cover more court.
Martina Hingis winning the second set in dramatic fashion. Here live at Madison Square Garden. Steffi Graf up a break.
in the third set and up 15 love. Forehand.
Well, the server is just struggling. There's only been three holds of serve in the last 11 games. Wow.
Seven breaks of serve in that second set.
Miss hit. 30-15, Groff. In the second set, and what really stands out is the fact that Martina Hingis, 11 winners to only 4 for Groff.
Yeah, things really turned around for Steffi Graf. She had 16 winners in the first set, only 4 in the second set, and the unforced errors were pretty close with the two.
And converting on 4 of 5 breakpoint opportunities against Graf, that is clutch.
Is able to hold to go up 2-love here in the third set. Tonight on ABC, an hour of America's Funniest Home Videos, followed by the most outrageous hour of the week. Drew Carey and Mimi Guest on Lois and Clark, and this one you won't believe. Also, Wings' Crystal Bernard stars in the world premiere of Dying to be Perfect, the Alan Hart Pena story, all tonight here on ABC. Hingis opens her service game with the forehand winner. Robin Roberts, along with Betsy Nagelson and Pam Shriver, here at Madison Square Garden. Chase Championships final, the season-ending championships. Best of 5. Hey, thanks for putting our names up. Don't get much face time when you do this.
Wow. Serve.
Whoa.
On a second serve. That's an eye-opener. You know, you gotta like the fact she tries different things.
Starting to connect is Graf on the forehand side. Just so much power off that side. Tremendous hip rotation.
Well, real trouble for Hingis now. She's already down the break, and Graf looking to take charge of this third set. A couple of points for a 3-love lead. Oh.
As she's down love 3 in the third set. Is that her second double fault? 1988 final between Gabriella Sabatini and I love the hair, Pam. Nice hair. In the final, after beating Chris Severn in the quarters and Steffi Graf, but you didn't beat Gabriella Sabatini in the final. Still a valiant effort.
Yeah, and there's one that's still playing a little bit on the tour. The other one's retired.
But, you know, you did snap Graf's 46-match win streak, 88.
You know,
it was a Golden Slam year for
that was the most fun singles match in my career here at the Garden, that semifinal. Loved it.
And Chrissy in the quarters, not too shabby.
Graf only lost to 2 people that whole year, you and Sabatini.
How much are you getting paid for all this?
I still haven't recovered.
just long.
Graf's had a lot of years where she's only lost a couple of matches. In 95, that's what you mentioned earlier, she only lost to Kutzer and DeSwart. This year, she's just had four losses.
1-2 Martina Hingis.
1-2 Dante, who just retired this week in Fed Cup. That was 12-10 in the final set.
Wow, 53-4.
Graf held a match point in that match against Kimiko Date. Semifinals of the Fed Cup.
She also lost to Lindsay Davenport in the semis of L.A. And the Novotna loss after losing the first set in Philadelphia.
She's won six tournaments this year, Goff. She's entered 10. And Pam, as you mentioned at the beginning of the show, she couldn't finish two of them.
Again, coming to net. Oh, just missing us. Hingis.
Missed it, but a great play. I mean, it shows the variety of the plays in Martina Hingis's repertoire, that she would attack the serve, come in behind it, just miss the backhand volley. Now, this is in a 3-out-of-5 set match. I'm not sure Hingis should really try to battle to get back in this set. Just get her rhythm back, figure that this third set is probably gone, and get herself ready for the fourth. So shorten up the points. I mean, that's a good tactic there as well. What you don't want to be doing is spending the next 20 minutes to a half hour trying to get into the fourth, maybe get back to 5-3, lose it anyway.
And concedes that point. Excellent lob by Graf. Another quick point. 30-15, Hingis. Great touch there by Steffi Graf. That's her eighth winner, twice as many as she had in the second set.
Hingis only with four. Of course, she hasn't won a game in this third set.
Oh, that's so good.
Graf yelled, and then she realized Hingis actually made a play on that. She said yes with her forehand return. She thought it was an outright winner. And then she got a little embarrassed. See, we stay on Steffi here. She starts to say yes, and then, oops. Now she realizes the little one nearly got it.
The Swiss miss.
It's unbelievable, though, how Graf can create such incredible pace. He has one of the strongest, quickest wrists because the ball gets, you know, a little bit behind Graf on that forehand side, and she can still bust winners. Timing is unbelievable.
Point there.
You would not teach kids to hit the forehand as late as Steffi Graf hits it. However, you wouldn't mind the result.
That being said, so the break point's one. Ooh, serve and volley. And she's broken for a third time in the fourth set. And Steffi Graf will serve for the third set when we come back here to New York City. Stay with us.
Speaking of bathroom breaks, Martina used to take a few.
A look back to the emotional night Martina Navratilova ended her tennis career. After losing her last career match to Gabriela Sabatini, Madison Square Garden raised Martina's banner to the rafters in a farewell ceremony extravaganza.
Live here at Madison Square Garden, the banner of Martina Navratilova, who won 167 singles titles, and earlier this year, Steffi Graf reached 100, only one of three players in the open era to do that.
And I bet Chris Everett was the other one.
Very good. You advance to the front of the class, Pam Shriver. And earlier this week, yet another retirement ceremony. Remember, Martina Navratilova. And Gabriella Sabatini, who retired Monday night. She was the one who put Martina out. Mr. C, Bill Cosby on hand. Festive night. Steffi Graf and Monica Seles. And a great champion. Quite popular.
Of course, she won two titles here at the Garden.
Finally broke that very long drought she had right here at the end of 94.
Beating Lindsay Davenport.
Yeah, and then she won the first term of 95. And kind of thought maybe she was going to get back into it. And everyone was going to get to see one of their favorite players, Sabatini, back in the winning circle. I think she had just had enough, and at age 26, called it quits.
Well, if you're wondering why it took so much time to get the players back, they took one of their bathroom breaks. First, Martina Hingis raced out, and then Steffi Graf figured, well, what the heck, I might as well go, too.
Good as time as any, leading 5-love in the third set.
But we three stayed right here.
That's right. Sometimes you got to play hurt. Opening up with a double fault, her first of the match.
We don't have year-long stats on what you do after bathroom breaks, but that's probably not that unusual to come back and put in a bad point.
We'll keep you in charge of that stat, okay? The outright winner by Graf, 15-all. Too much knowledge. Steffi Graf changed her shirt during the potty break. And a 40-15 lead for Graf.
Double set point.
Sets to one in this best of five.
And towards the end of that game in the set, Hingis was just saying, okay, let's get this nightmare of a third set out of the way. Love six. Now she's ready to start serving. This is when we'll see how mature the 16-year-old is. Can she clean the slate and start all over in the fourth?
They've been playing for an hour and 34 minutes. A lot of court left open for Martina Hingis. She really needs a hold to start the fourth set.
Well, she needs a hold, period, because she has only held twice in the last two sets. She was able to win the second set despite only holding service twice.
Oh, her third double fault. That second serve, only 69 miles an hour, but well placed. Able to hold serve to begin the fourth set. More of the
Chase Championships when we come back. Square Garden. The fourth set, Steffi Graf leading 2-1 against Martina Hingis, her first service game of the fourth set.
That's right. Look at here, the Graf forehand close to the sideline, but it was a shot before that Hingis thought was maybe wide, but she maintained her composure.
Yeah, because she pulled up a little bit and then regathered herself.
Well, the side linesman or lines lady put her hands up to her face saying that she could not see the call. So Jane Harvey explaining there to Steffi Graf that she was unsighted, therefore the umpire had to make the call of fault and a double fault.
Beautiful shot there by the 16-year-old Hingis. Great points.
Showing off some excellent touch early on here that's been working for her. She loves this shot. She has such a good feel off that backhand side. We've seen her belt them down the line for winners, mix it up with the topspin lob. Double break point here.
And she does come through with the break. And it's Hingis going up 2-0 in the fourth set. And let's show you what happened in this third set, which Steffi Graf won at love. 9 winners as compared to 4 for Hingis.
Only 3 unforced errors, Betsy, and no break points did Graf face in that third set, but she's already dropped her serve in the fourth. You know, thinking about Graf's match last year with Huber, Graf won the first set, lost the second, won the third, dropped the fourth, and as of right now, we are following a very similar pattern. Of course, when you only play one of these type matches a year, it's really hard to discuss patterns.
The crowd is trying to help everyone out. The scoreboard is incorrect. It's saying 1-1 in the fourth, when indeed it's Hingis leaving 2-0. And the crowd just thought maybe they didn't realize that. Help them out.
It's funny when we talked to Martina yesterday about playing, you know, best of 5-set match. She's never done that before. She says, oh, no, I played a couple of matches, sometimes 3 matches in the juniors. All I had to do then was go from court to court. She didn't seem bothered by a possibility of playing 5 tough sets out here today.
But Graf is bothering her here at the break point now.
Well, Steffi did a little motion there because she was not pleased with her backhand return. She just put it back into play in the middle of the court, and Hingis can step around and do what Graf likes to do, which is hit a big forehand. But look at her ready to move forward.
Oh.
job again of mixing up the shots.
It's a big game for Hingis. Yeah. She held serve, then broke Roth for 2-love. Has faced a break point in this game, and now has come back and now a game point for 3-love.
She has no nerves. She can't. She must not.
I think that time she saw Graf moving forward because she knows when Hingis gets a short ball, she's probably going to drop it short. She's done it a lot this match.
Quickly between points, she really is one of the fastest players, and here you can see once again the forehand doing the damage down the line.
Rom also a fast player, and yes, Martina Hingis is able to hold, and she takes a 3-love lead in the fourth set. Live here at Madison Square Garden. Steffi Graf opening the game with her fifth ace. She now leads 30-love. She's down love 3 in this fourth set. Loves that backhand, doesn't he?
Well, you never expect people to go off like that. It's almost like a baseball player that's late on a fastball, but she went with it beautifully and hit the winner in the corner.
Hingis just able to get a racket on the serve. I told you she loved the backhand. 16 winners on the backhand side compared to 5 for Graf.
Four games worth of backhand winners. Ace number 6 for Graf.
7 between the two of them. Remember, $250 each ace this weekend goes to Althea Gibson, who's having some health problems. The great Althea Gibson.
A lead can disappear very quickly against Steffi Graf. It's only a one-break lead.
Another backhand winner.
What she does so well, Hingis, is off that backhand side, is that she moves forward. She cuts off any angle. Watch her step just inside the baseline to play it. Just too good from Graf. She moves the ball so well around the court. Hingis just couldn't quite get behind it.
Now she'll maybe take a couple extra seconds to catch her win. That's the only time. Otherwise, she plays in about 7 or 8 seconds between points. You're allowed 20.
Steffi maybe takes, 9. Not much more. Schoolgirl squeal, just too much. And now she faces two break points.
Groff trying to get the break back in this set. Of course, if you're going to lose your serve, lose your opening service game in a set, you have plenty of time to get the service break back. That was a good first serve that set up that point for Hingis. Fights off one of the break points. Now we'll see what kind of serve. Does she just spin it in and make sure she gets it in, or does she go for it again?
That one was a 90-mile-per-hour serve.
At the end of that, she nearly stumbled into the net. Look at that.
She's taking her time now. She's like, I get 20 seconds? I really get 20 seconds?
She's like, can the crowd please give me a little more ovation? Heart rate's up at 180. It's going down maybe to 170 right about now.
Two break points saved.
She did that on purpose. You know, when you're really winded, serve a let serve. It gives you an extra 10, 15 seconds.
Good strategy. Never thought of that.
Well, have you ever been winded, Robin, on the tennis court?
Oh, hardy har har.
What a difficult shot that is, and if you're not behind the ball, it's such a tough shot to play. This one gets away from her just a little bit, skidded through. This court plays awfully quickly and just misses wide. So a third break opportunity in this game for Graf.
Hingis is definitely a little winded in this game. Now that's a gift.
Well, and she is so happy because, wow. I mean, she has only had to work so hard the last few points, and to get a quick point, not only does she get back to deuce, but now she can recover a little bit better and be better prepared for a long rally in case it comes up. Sort of flexed her bicep muscle there. I'm not sure at 16 she has much of one, but great effort.
Misses there just. Steffi's gonna take a second look.
Even Martina called it out, just in case.
Which I hate, and a lot of veterans hate on the tour, where the young kids come on left over from the junior days, they make the call.
Oh, come on, she's just caught up in the moment. Just caught up in the moment of what's going on.
Now from four break points down, she's got herself an ad here.
Oh, see that strategy again. Yep. Nalette, give herself a little extra time.
Another let. You know, there's some talk in tennis of all the rules that might change. Eliminating lets is one of the rules that is talked about as possibly changing in the future.
And Hingis able to hold off four break points. And she's up 4-1 here in the fourth set. Back with more of the Chase Championships of the...
This year's Wimbledon Championship was the second Grand Slam final between Steffi Graf and Arantxa Sanchez Vicario this year. When it was over, Graf had won her seventh Wimbledon final, a 6-3, 7-5 straight sets victory, which also marked Steffi's 100th career singles title. As we said earlier, one of only three women in the modern era to have a 100 or more. Chris Everett and Martina Navratilova, the other two.
And Graf's the only player to have at least four of all the Grand Slams. That, to me, of everything, to me, is most outstanding.
If she plays and wins the Australian Open, she'll have five of everything, which is even more amazing. She's missed the Australian Open the last couple of years due to injury.
Wimbledon final quickly. We saw in the highlights there Graf hitting an overhead, but the shot that I will always remember most is the one where she was 2 yards from the net and whiffed the overhead. Swung and missed. Made club players so happy.
I was thinking the same thing. Hackers all across the world rejoice. Her third double fault. Remember, she's down a break here in the fourth.
And the way both players have been having trouble holding serve, I'm sure Hingis would love to try to get a second break.
This match approaching the 2 hour mark.
Oh my goodness, that serve nearly hit the baseline.
I know I sound like a broken record, but break point for Martina Hingis.
A concerned person looking on is Heinz Gunhardt. Last year he had to sit through five sets before Steffi Graf won the championships.
She seems to be hobbling just a little bit, maybe cramps or something.
And Steffi's actually was holding the back of her back. So perhaps both players, we have seen the best tennis in the last couple of games as far as length of rallies. She's a little tired, but she's happy. She's serving for the fourth set, up 5-1.
That was almost as if she felt something in Martina's back there. She kind of winced as though something caught. Any case, she's up 5-1.
5-1 in the fourth. She's trying to stretch out her leg. Her mobility is limited right now.
Well, I believe that was going to be an outright winner from anywhere. She went for this backhand, and she didn't hit the winner, and so she didn't even try to recover, and a great flick of the wrist from Groff's forehand.
She got it.
The second serve ace, her third. Nine aces now in the game, in the match, excuse me.
Crowd always loves when the ball gets stuck in the net. It brings laughter every time. You'd think they would have gotten tired of it.
They're easily amused. Just long. Again, Groff down. Two breaks in this fourth set.
Now, they've been out on court for 2 hours exactly. Hingis has struck a lot of winners off that racket in this fourth set. The third set, she only hit 4 winners. She's got herself 13 in this set.
And a break point for Steffi Graf, one of the two breaks back possibility. Steffi Graf is able to get one of the breaks back. She's still down 2-5 here in the fourth set at Madison Square Garden. Martina Hingis was attended to. It seems like she's having a problem with her quad muscle, and this is what happened earlier. And you can see her in obvious discomfort. She's still up a break in the fourth set. Asked for the trainer to come out. And the big ovation that you hear, she's taking a little bit longer to take her position as her mother looks on. But is now ready to face Groff again here in the fourth. 7 aces now for Steffi Graf. Steffi yesterday, Pam, she said also she was down to best of 5. If she was down, she wanted quick points. If she was down like this, 2-5.
It really was the first test for Hingis since Kathleen Stroya came out to examine her on the change of ends, moving quickly to the drop shot, going the one-hander, good touch, and Graf almost gets the lob over Hingis's head. She's able to just get her racket head on the overhead.
And now she has a set point. Talk about the momentum changing in this match. We go to deuce.
And Graf led 30-11. This game started off the game with two aces in a row, and when she dropped the sixth game of this set, she was up 30-love again and dropped 4 points in a row. It's very unusual to see Graf dropping serves from 30-love up.
Now three aces in this game.
Nine now for Steffi Graf.
Side. That was the best one and the first one we've seen off the forehand side. It is a tougher side to hit that kind of feel drop shot, but played to perfection.
And now Steffi again, a point away from holding serve. Martina Hingis will serve for the fourth set.
And I'm not sure Steffi Graf's feeling 100% either. Bit of grimace there from Steffi. Remember, both players played three-set semifinals yesterday, so this is their seventh set. And Hingis is having some serious problems now with her left quad.
Definitely. Trying to stretch it out a bit.
She's serious. Is that I'm almost wondering whether she cramped.
That's what I'm thinking. That it's a cramp. That
it could be.
Started a couple of games ago.
She's trying to walk it off, shake it off. You know, 2 hours, 8 minutes into this match. And as you said, Pam, she did play three sets, and she was the second semi on yesterday.
Well, it's going to affect her serve because it's the left thigh, it looks as though, and that's the leg she uses more on the serve.
And her fifth double fault, and she definitely is having problems and is calling to Jane Harvey to cheer up.
Her mom looking on has to be turmoiled inside. She sure doesn't look it. She got a warning for taking too much time. it's a loss of conditioning in that it is cramping. So she cannot take an injury timeout.
So, of course, Steffi's sensing that, trying to make her move, and Hingis is trying for the points to be as short as possible.
Now you just feel so badly for her.
Two break points for Groff. And so it's the break for Steffi Graf as Martina Hingis will be attended to. And she is leaving the court, as you can see. She's still leading 5-4 in the fourth set. Steffi Graf will serve when we come back, and we'll keep a close eye on Martina Hingis, the hurting 16-year-old at this point. Back live here at Madison Square Garden, Steffi Graf to go 5-all in the fourth set, about to serve, but it's Martina Hingis, so many are concerned with right now, was definitely cramping severely at the end of that last game. Hingis serving. She was still up a break in the fourth.
Well, all the weight is on her left leg when she serves, and all it does is aggravate the cramp even more. It happened at 4-1 when she had a point for 5-1. You could see her wince. Now this is where she got a warning for taking too much time, a code violation. And this is Steffi with an ice bag on her left knee, which we know has been bothering her. It's the reason she had to pull out of Leipzig.
Martina Hingis is still off the court, and Pam Shriver has left the broadcast booth. She's down. And Pam, what can you tell us?
Well, I'm sitting alongside Kathleen Stroyan. Obviously, Kathleen, who is looking after the players, can you give us some information on what's going on with Martina Hingis?
Martina started to cramp in her left quadricep.
Of course, that is a loss of condition, so you are not allowed to. What can you do for a loss of condition?
Under our rule, we cannot treat any cramping, so all I can do is evaluate her and advise her.
So she, in fact, didn't strain a muscle. It has been a cramp from the very beginning?
Yes.
So at this point, she's taking her second bathroom break. Is that what's going on?
She's taking a bathroom break or a change of attire break.
And you're allowed to have 5 minutes under that situation?
Yes, you're allowed to have two change of attire or bathroom breaks for 5 minutes per match.
Are you allowed to give her any verbal advice or anything, or do you have to stay totally out of the situation?
Stay out of the situation.
And that, again, is a situation we have seen in tennis many times at Grand Slams, oftentimes in the men's game when it gets into the fourth or fifth set. You see it. We saw Shuzo Matsuoka not too long ago basically being laid down on the court at the U.S. Open. No one could attend to them. It must be frustrating for you, Kathleen.
It's difficult, yes, to sit here and watch it.
Okay, let's go back upstairs to Robin and Betsy.
Thank you, Pam and Kathleen. And this is where it actually happened right here. A point to go 5-1.
You could see it just looked like it just caught. She put her hand down the leg, and she sort of looked like she's stretching her back. That's why I thought maybe she had pulled something in her back. And
in the last game, she re-injured her quadricep.
Because she had to serve.
This is back live. Steffi Graf on the court, and we will have more of the Chase Championships of the Corral WTA Tour after these messages from our ABC stations. Oh gosh. Thank you. Live here at Madison Square Garden, Martina Hingis was able to return to the court, though she's down 30 love. Here in the fourth set, she was up two breaks. And now brought 2 points from the 5-all in the fourth.
She's obviously hurting, but she's moving fairly well. It's the left thigh that began when she had a point for foot to go up 5-1, which she broke. Graf took a 5-1 lead with two breaks. Graf has since broken back twice and is serving to tie the fourth set up.
At all when you know your opponent is hurting a little bit?
I mean, sometimes it's very distracting because you're just thinking more about your opponent than your own shots. And she's obviously going to try to move Hingis as much as she can.
Oh! Whoops. Just missing the ace. Second serve, 40-30 Graf. Down 4-5 in the fourth.
Forehand volley from Hingis, and when she did come back to the court, evidently it was she didn't take a bathroom break. She took a shirt change, which again, you can have two during a 3 out of 5 set match. The same rule as a 2 out of 3 setter. So she's used both hers up.
A lot out of Martina Hingis.
Well, I see some shaky signs from Steffi Graf. She's missed a couple of shots in this game that is typical of when you are facing somebody who is physically under some duress. Sometimes you get uptight as well.
Here was unbelievable. And then she lets Graf commit herself to the net and goes down behind her, drills the forehand down the line to get it back to deuce. It's going to be the service game of Hingis that will cause her the most trouble. Her own serve. As a right-hander, when you go up to serve, most of the pressure is on that left leg. That's where you generate the knee bend and shove off mostly with that left leg.
She thought she had the ace again.
I'll tell you what, I'm sitting about 15 feet from that net, and I didn't hear it either. I'll tell you, when you think you've served an ace to level it at 5-all after being down 4-1, 5-1. It's
disheartening.
A little upset.
That's
well, it's a pretty gutty performance. I don't think young Hingis would have ever been in this situation before. Not, needless to say, a fourth set, but also having battled through some cramps and still trying to win us the fourth set. A lot of drama.
A big serve from Graf. She led 30-love in this game. It's been a long game, a couple of deuces already. Deuce number 4. Oh.
Advantage Graf.
Are so special. She really is. It's amazing being down this close and seeing them, of course, battling another game point here. That stretching backhand volley gives Hingis plenty of time, but she stays so calm and cool. I mean, a lot of people can get up tight with that kind of easy forehand.
Game. She's had several chances to tie up this fourth set.
And a second set point for Hingis. Excuse me, number 3.
She is.
And the crowd definitely on her side. You know, the New York crowd, they love an underdog. And she's hurting and she's giving them all that she has. For the second year in a row, now Betsy,
yeah.
5 sets.
Steffi Graf beat Anke Huber last year in five sets. Anke Huber went out in the first round here to Eva Maioli.
And it was 6 years ago that the first five-set final when Sabatini and Selys clashed in their final, and that was the first time that these championships went the distance.
That was a classic back in 1990.
Exploiting the lack of mobility that's still pretty obvious. Three break points here, love 40.
And indeed, Steffi Graf opens the fifth and deciding set with the break. Leading one love here in the fifth. She's hurting as well. Much more to come, everyone. Back live here at Madison Square Garden. As you can see, Pam Shriver right there in the middle of the action.
Well, Robin and Betsy, Martina Hingis on the changeover asked Kathleen Stroya to go get her a sleeve for the quad. So right now, Kathleen has just helped Martina. Actually, she's decided not to put on the sleeve, but more like an insurance-type policy. So Kathleen Stroya, the trainer, is a very busy woman at this point.
She is earning her money, and the winner of this match will earn $500,000. $500,000 to the winner. Again, exploiting the lack of mobility by Hingis.
This is it.
This will bring you up to date on what is happening. 66% of first serves for Steffi Graf. She's 63% for Martina Hingis. And you see the winners, but the unforced errors. A lot of them coming late in the match with Hingis hurting 55.
Hingis lost that third set, 6-love. Only hit four winners in the fourth set. She had 22 winners. Also had 22 unforced errors. It's a good idea for Hingis. I mean, she's going to swing away. She does not want long points, so she'll try to crack a winner if she can. So from a break point to a game point for Graf, try to go up 2-love in this fifth set.
Back to deuce. Steffi Graf.
Well, because of that big first serve, she doesn't need to work as hard as Hingis does to try and hold on to Hingis's serve. So that's a big advantage right now for Brock.
Hear someone shout from the crowd. And so the chair ump, Jane Harvey, saying, shut up! Politely, though.
She's English. Of course she's going to be polite.
Eight times Hingis has. She's done a very good job of converting on break points. 8 of 14.
See again, favoring her quadricep. Down a break in the final set. Deuce number four. Groff again, a point away from going up too low.
Has really had to work on her serve. 10 deuces in her last two service games combined. Whereas Hingis got broken at love in the first game of this fifth.
Her fifth double fault. Deuce for an 11th time. Her last two service games.
Martina Hingis is dropping her racket a lot now, and it's a situation where she should save every last drop of energy for the match.
It wasn't easy, but Brock holds to take a 2-love lead here in the fifth set. Tomorrow night on ABC, the most powerful Dangerous Minds episode of the year. Annie Potts stars in Dangerous Minds. Plus, Dan Marino and the Dolphins have their hands full as the Pittsburgh Steelers come to town on ABC's Monday Night Football. Check your local listings for the times in your area. So the mother looking on right there, the coach.
You're exactly right, Robin. It's got to be very tough for Martina's mom to be seeing what's happening out here with a daughter in so much pain.
That's when the mom does take over, I believe, and the coach kind of takes a back seat. Hingis down love 30 on her serve. She was broken in the first game of this fifth set. There again.
You can see at the end of the Hingis serve, she lands on that left leg. She's trying to avoid doing it.
Changing her service motion.
Yep.
Easily seen that. It's a double break for Steffi Graf.
Secret Service motion has completely changed. She's not able to produce the serve that she would like.
Footfall by Hingis, as you were saying, Pam. Excuse me, Betsy, trying to change her service motion, causing the footfall. And she's down love three here in the fifth set. Live here at Madison Square Garden, side of the Chase Championship to the Correll WTA Tour. In the fifth set, the only best of five in women's tennis, Steffi Graf up two breaks, leading 3-love in the fifth. Martina Hingis injured her quad, now has decided to go with the sleeve. He wins the first point. Jumps out quickly. Love 30. Now.
And Robin and Betsy, I'm sitting with Kathleen Story. And Kathleen, you've had to go out in the last couple of changeovers to talk to Martina Hingis. What's the update with the leg?
Martina asked for a pair of sleeve to wear on her thigh because she wanted the compression and the support.
And how's the Graf knee? Have you seen her ice it during the last couple of changeovers?
It's bothering her a little bit. She has patellar tendonitis.
Well, oftentimes, Kathleen, I know through the years, when you have these long matches, players aren't used to playing the fourth and fifth set. Do you think that's a reason why you're so busy in this fifth set?
Yes, I think that definitely is a factor.
Robin?
40-30. Graf a point away, taking a commanding 4-love lead here in this fifth set. And she does. She now leads 4-love here in the fifth, tied at 2 sets apiece. And you can see that Steffi Graf, yes, she's also with her left knee.
And that's been a problem of hers for the last several months. She had to pull out of Leipzig a couple of weeks ago because of that patella tendonitis.
And she wasn't sure whether or not she could play Philadelphia. She actually was entered and then pulled out and then re-entered. Didn't play till Thursday in Philly, but it was the back that ended up hurting her in Philly.
I think she felt, Pam, probably that she needed to play some matches because she hadn't played anything for several weeks. Since the U.S. Open.
She said before that this could extend her career, knowing that she can still win the big tournaments and not put in the training that she normally did.
Well, finally, a point on the scoreboard for Hingis. This is her fifth service game since she hurt herself, and that's only the fifth point she's won in all five service games, so she is definitely troubled when having to serve. She lost her 4 previous service games. Another foot fault call.
And as you said, Betsy, her service game is giving her the most problems because that's where she puts the bulk of the weight on that injured left leg.
And of course, she's changing the mechanics because she's trying not to cause pain in the left leg. And by changing the mechanics, she is foot faulting. She is not known for foot faulting.
She's going to go out fighting, that's for sure.
I'm sure Steffi's been over there kind of waiting for her to go away for the last, you know, set in some games. Remember, this happened at 4-1 Hingis in the fourth set.
And now a point away for winning her first game here in the fifth.
reminder, again, we spoke about it earlier, each player is playing their eighth set of singles in just over 24 hours. That would be more singles than either one of them would have played in their career within a just over a 24-hour span.
Second game point for Martina Hingis.
You can see she's actually figured out how to serve now without moving her left leg. She's keeping it very still.
And of course, when you change your mechanics, that's when something else can start to hurt, like your arm suddenly can start to go off, because instead of using your leg and your usual push-up, you're using more arm.
A break point for Groff. Madison Square Garden, the two players receiving a standing ovation as Steffi Graf about to serve for the match against Hingis. And she opens with her 12th ace. And quickly takes a 30-love lead. Did you hear that one, Pam?
Loud and clear.
Oh, just checking. Why not? Martina Hingis, as she tried to play on, and she did, but nonetheless, it is Steffi Graf winning her fifth season-ending championship. 6-3, 4-6, 6-love, 4-6, 6-love. Steffi Graf, $500,000 richer, and Pam Shriver will talk to the 96 champion when we come back here to New York.
Well, I think it was when it was 4-1, I think, when she started to stretch her legs constantly, and obviously when she started to serve at 5-2, I think it was.
We concentrated well to close it out in the fifth. Congratulations on winning another Chase Championships. Robin?
All right, Pam, thank you very much. Steffi Graf, her fifth victory. For Pam Shriver and Betsy Nagelson, I'm Robin Roberts. Thanks for joining us, everyone. The ITT LPGA Tour Championship coming up next right here on ABC. Take care.